Good evening, everyone. I'll say a short prayer, which Dr. Rashid already said in the morning before starting his speech. Rabbi shrahli sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul ughdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Because what I am trying to present here in the topic, embracing and managing diversity, is something which is very close to my heart. And I would like to start it by asking a question. Okay, so the question is, how many of you know, or whoever could raise their hands, which emirates is connected to all the rest of the six emirates in UAE physically by borders? Which emirate is connected?
Sharjah.
Alhamdulillah. So we could be having this workshop in Dubai, and possibly the expats would not know. But alhamdulillah, Sharjah is connected to all the emirates. And why I asked this question and started by asking this question, just like Sharjah, project managers are the connecting points for all the stakeholders that are on the project. And they act as a focal point. On paper, many a times, they are said to be the single point of contact, mostly for technology projects. And this is the responsibility of project manager to create that rhythm and show as a leadership the direction to the entire team and the other rest of the stakeholders as well. So for this reason, instead of, although many would think that the topic is more relevant to possibly HR, who drives diversity in the organization, but in my view, this becomes an equal responsibility of project leaders to lead the way. And while leading the way, so why this topic in, essentially itself is that this topic is very important, very pertinent today and was always. When we start the project, we start with a hope of that everybody would be like us, like-minded on the project. Somebody is clicking. No, I'm not clicking. Okay, I don't know. Is it happening for this clicker only? I am not pushing. Okay, so when you start the project, it is with the hope that everybody will be like-minded and everybody will be as enthusiastic as you are on the project, with the most famous emoji, big smile on the face, and tear of joys with saying, okay, I would want to be part of. But reality is a bit different. And reality is more of, most of the time, that we've come up with different people from different backgrounds and different ages and so on and so forth. And most of them, if you are not acquiring them, would be part of your team by virtue of default. So you, at point in time, you will get to acquire them yourself as project managers, but it could be that you are not the one who you have acquired the team itself. Many would say in project management or being a leader that the more diverse the workforce is on the project, more difficult it is to manage them. But in my view, and they would think that this is a recipe for disaster, if you have diverse minds working and they are not coming along together. But in my view and my personal view with my experiences, this is a recipe of success. Hopefully, I will be able to show this to you today. So, what is diversity is the first question that should come to our mind. So, in general, there are about 7.7 billion people on the planet today, and all of us are different and unique. But we group ourselves in our minds as humans in one group or the other, and in many groups as a person. So a person could be a female, and they then could be a Pakistani, and so on and so forth. Yeah? So diversity, being unique, is composite term that has been used for ethnicity, language, interests, learning styles, talents, hobbies, religion, sports, abilities, political backgrounds, or affiliations, height, gender, even hair color, age, and personality. In today's environment, the topic is generally considered to be more aligned with ethnicity and gender diversification in the organization, but equally important are all these other diversifications that we have. And when we come on a project, we come with all these gambits of differentiations. More so in corporate world, we could be belonging to different departments and different teams. That is also a diversification. But the most important thing is that as humans, we are wired differently in our brains. And physically, the brain itself, like fingerprint, is an organ that is different for each one of us. It is unique, and the anatomy of the brain is very unique for each one of us. So Einstein, especially, his brain, when it was studied, unfortunately, it was dissected and studied, it was found out that he had a very typical style of brain, and one of the things that was noticed because of him playing violin, it was differently designed by God. Okay? So everyone is differently wired, and hence we act and react differently.